Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel, and in our today's video we will simulate the multi-stage compression process using Aspen HYSYS. We have already simulated multi-stage compression using Aspen Plus, and that was a simple module which was available as M compressor, but here the procedure will be different for the multi-stage compression system. So in the representation of the multi-stage compression system, there is no module available in Aspen HYSYS as M compressor or multi-stage compressor. In fact, we have to place the equipment in the same style as that of the multi-stage compression system, which is available as a single module in Aspen Plus. So how it is started? If we are assuming the humidity process, then obviously we will consider the stream saturator over here, that the air is entering, water is feed, and feed air, which is the humid air as per our requirement, will be fed to this compressor, which is comp 1. And the compressed air is coming out of this compressor at high pressure, which is cooled down using this heat exchanger, with cooling media being the cooling water which is coming from the cooling towers. This cooled air is then sent to this flash separator, where the produced condensate, which is available in air in form of the moisture, is separated here from the bottom, while the air stream then moves to the second compressor and again cooled down and again passed through the separator. This shows the first stage of the compressor, which include compressor number 1, heat exchanger, separator. Obviously, this pump is excluded out of this system, you can see, because it is available for provision of the cooling water to the coolers. This one is the interstage cooler and this one is the after stage cooler, because these are the two systems or two stage systems. If there are three stages, then there will be two intercoolers and obviously one after cooler. So accordingly, this will be processed in the system. So this is the overall representation of two stage compression system, and we will simulate it in Aspen HYSYS. If you increase the number of stages, then accordingly the set, which is compressor, heat exchanger and separator, will be further increased as well, and accordingly you might need to provide cooling water more in the system, or there is a chance that you provide separate cooling water to this one and this one. Currently, the cooling water from the heat exchanger 1, which is coming out of this heat exchanger, is entering this heat exchanger. There could be another arrangement that cooling water is split here and partially supplied to it and partially supplied to it. But currently in our arrangement, we are assuming this pattern as has been shown here as well. So in the air specifications, we are given that 50% humid air is entering at a temperature of 25 degrees centigrade, pressure of 1.01325 bar or 1 atm, with a flow rate of 100 kg mole per hour. And before getting humid, the original air specification is nitrogen molar composition 0.78, oxygen 0.21, argon 0.01. Then in water specification, 25 degree centigrade, 1 atm or 1.01325 bar, 2000 kg mole per hour, and composition for water is 1. Then in the compressors, the specification, that the compression ratio is 3 for both compressors, and we usually say that the compression ratio remains the same for all the stages. So accordingly, we are taking that concept here. For the heat exchangers, the outer temperature of air in both case, means in intercooler and aftercooler, it is 30 degrees centigrade with a pressure drop of 0.1 bar at both shell side and tube side. So let's quickly go to Aspen HYSYS and simulate this process. So we will add the components nitrogen, oxygen, argon, water, which are our required components for the system, and the fluid package for the air separation system, as we have discussed before, is Peng-Robinson. So going to the simulation environment, and first we will select the stream saturator. So we will select it and place it over here, and we will give its required connection. Feed stream is obviously air. For water, we can say simply as water, and product as feed air, which is sent to the compression system. And accordingly, we need to specify the air as 25 degrees centigrade, 1.01325 bar, 100 kg mole per hour, and accordingly the fractions are 0.78 mole fraction for nitrogen, 0.21 for oxygen, and 0.01 for argon, and click on OK. And going to this design parameters and selecting it as 50% relative humidity, so we will get the composition as 0.7677 for nitrogen, 0.2067 for oxygen, 0.0098 for argon, and 0.0158 for water. After going through this, what we will do, we will select compressor first, then we will select the heat exchanger, and then we will select a flash separator. So we will do the connection one by one, and what we need to do, this one is compressor 1, quickly doing its connections. That feed air is its inlet, comp 1 outlet, and W comp 1 is the power required for it. And in worksheet, either we can specify pressure over here or in design parameters, we have been given that the pressure ratio or the compression ratio is 3. So we will simply select 3 over here and it will be solved. So that is a very simple procedure to do it. Next, this outlet air will go to this heat exchanger and we will specify it in shell side as conf 1 out and this one is as HEX 1 out. Obviously, we have specified one side, but we need to specify the other side, which is of cooling water. So what we need to do, we need to select a pump from here and accordingly doing the connections that cooling water in, cooling water out, work required for pump. And we have been given that it is at 25 degrees centigrade, 1.01325 bar, 2000 kg mol per hour with composition of water as 1 and the compression ratio, compressors was 3 and here the compression ratio is 3 as well. So now connecting this cooling water out to this one and this will be cooling water out and that will be HEX1W out and naming it as HEX1. Now we have been given that the pressure drop at both shell side and tube side is 0.1 bar each and the outlet temperature of air from the heat exchanger is 30 degrees centigrade. So it has been converged successfully. After going through this air, which is HEX1 out and this one is the cooling water, so I will simply take it out over here. We'll go to this flash separator and that will be HEX1 out and labeling it as SEP1 and accordingly doing the connections as SEP1 out 1 and SEP1 out 2. And you can see in out 2, which is liquid, 0.1098 kg mol per hour of the stream is produced and that is purely water stream. So water which is produced from the system is removed here. And here we can say that first stage of compression is completed with compressor, heat exchanger and separator. Now moving to the second stage system and how it will proceed, that we will select the compressor, then the heat exchanger and then the flash separator and accordingly doing the connections over here, that the outlet from the separator will be the inlet of compressor 2, comp 2 out, work required for compressor 2 and the pressure ratio here is 3 and accordingly it has been converged and this one will go to the heat exchanger number 2 as compressor 2 outlet will be its inlet and HEX2 out. The water which is coming out from the HEX1 will be its inlet and HEX2W out and giving the pressure drops of 0.1 bars again in the same fashion for both shell side and tube side and the outlet temperature of air from this heat exchanger is 30 degrees centigrade and it is converged as well. And finally giving it to separator number 2 and accordingly you can see that once it is given to the separator, again it is divided into two parts and 0.9589 kg mol per hour of liquid is produced, which is water, and 100.5 kg mol per hour of the air is produced. So it can be sent to the further systems as per the requirement and aligning the system. And you can see this is the overall alignment or arrangement of two-stage compression system, with first stage considering compressor 1, heat exchanger 1, separator 1, second stage compressor 2, heat exchanger 2, which is after cooler for the system, and accordingly the separator 2. If CO2 is involved in the system, then accordingly adsorbers are considered, but these adsorber module is not available in Aspen, so accordingly we consider the component splitter for this operation. So that's how the multi-stage compression system is simulated using Aspen HYSYS. In Aspen Plus it was a single module, here single module is not available, so we have to connect all these one by one in series as you have seen here. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more videos.